What's up, guys? This is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure that you leave a like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, we will be talking about the query builder, okay? And more specifically, it will be the source query builder. Now, the things that I show you today can be used in pretty much any expression builder in QGIS and, I mean, SQL in general. So let's go ahead and get to it. So I have brought in my US county map. I have many counties here. What I want to do is just select one. All right, so I'll just do a random pick. And we see I picked in Nevada. Let's go ahead and go up here to the attribute table, bring that up to the top. And we see that we have the state FP of 32. All right, so let's go ahead and exit this. And now what I want to do, without clipping or performing any kind of new layer creation, I want to single out the Nevada counties. So how do I do that? Well, let me show you. Now that I'm in my layer properties, I will go to my source tab. So right now we're in information. Let's go to the source. The source tab will give you a layer name, the name of your layer. It will give you the data source encoding if you want to change that. I will not be changing that. And then it gives you the set source coordinate reference system. Okay, so when you change this reference system, you will need to update extents when you do that. And then it gives you this large clear box down here with a small button that says Query Builder. So let's go ahead and click on that. And if you recall, the number of that state FP of Nevada was 32, right? So let's build a query to single out those counties. So we'll click on state FP. You can just double click and it'll automatically show up down here in your expression box. If you want to see a sample size, a small sample of those state FPs, you hit sample and it'll give you a small sample size of those. If you want to see all of them, you hit all and it'll show you all of them. All right. And if you want to search through, let's say if you had strings or names or whatever, you could actually search right here. All right, so let's see what we want to do here. Let's go ahead and do the equal sign. I want to look for state FPs that have the number 32. This is what we're looking for. I'll hit test, and now I get an error. I get an error for some strange reason. So let me show you why I got this error. If I go to my attribute table and I look up that 32 or whatever it was, 32, bring it back up to the top. If I scroll over my fields here, I will see that each of these fields are strings. So if you're working with strings, you have to be specific in the expression that you build to let the program know, hey, this is not a integer. This is not a real number, whole number. This is a string. Okay. And we're doing string comparisons. So let's go back, exit this back to the layer, double click on that. And then back to Query Builder, state FP, hit my equal sign again. Now to be specific that I'm using strings, I will use these single quotation marks. I use two of them, one on each side, and then I put my 32. Now, if this was a regular number and I put 32, you will see it show up in the color red. But since it is a string, you see it in the color green. Now, if I test 32, test that, I see that there were 17 rows that were in this state. So I hit OK. And if I want to take a sample of those, sample, of course, it's only going to show me that 32 now because that is the expression that I have set in place. So I'll hit OK. And I'll move this out of the way so you can see that my entire map, that US map, is gone. All you can see here is the Nevada now. And if ever you want to save this, you need to make sure before you close this dialog box, you need to either hit apply or OK. If you do not, it will go back to the regular map. So I hit OK. And I'll go to this attribute table. And now in the attribute table, we only see those state FPs with the 32. Okay. On to the next thing. On the layer here, you will, if you're running a filter on the layer, you will see an icon come up here, which is showing, hey, this is a filtered layer. If you want to know what the filter does, you just hover over the icon and you'll see the filter state FP equals 32. So we'll go back into this layer, go into our query builder, and let's go ahead and run through some more things in here. So I'll go ahead and erase this. And let's just do some quick comparisons. Let's use the area land. And I'll hit test. Okay, so there are 3,220 counties here. And I'll say, okay, well, I want a small, or actually I'll just take all of them. And these are the sizes of the land mass of each of the counties. So let's do a comparison. I want to see the area of land that is less than, let's see, what do we want to do? Less than, we'll just pick a random arbitrary number and make it into a string and test. We have 735 rows. Now behind here, the map is updating these. If I close out of this, press okay, it has all of those specific counties now, and that is all we can see. Okay. And so you can kind of see how this is useful if you want to narrow down your vector layer without clipping, without making another layer, without doing all of that. So let's go ahead and now let's run a comparison like this. I want to see the area land, and I'll go ahead and test and then pull up some samples here. Area land less than equal to, what do we want it less than equal to? Wait, what happened to my samples here? Area land, looking for my samples. All, okay, there we are. Okay, so area land, and I want it to be less than, and you can also pick these up here, these buttons here, less than equal to, less than equal to maybe 240 million. Need to turn that into a string. And if you don't want to be turning these into strings all the time, all you need to do is go and convert the numbers into integers. You won't have to do this little quotation thing. But for me, I'm going to do the area land less than equal to this number and area of land greater than equal to, greater than equal to, let's just do 239. That's smaller, yeah, 239. And I'll run this, I'll test that out, and we see there are only 15 rows there. Now let me show you another way to do this formula where we're taking, we're basically making a range, and this is an inclusive range. So it's including the numbers that we have here. If it was not inclusive or it was exclusive, it would not be this type of comparison. We would be using just greater than and less than, so it wouldn't include these numbers. Okay, so out here on the map, you just go ahead and hit apply, whatever. These are the 15 that we have here. And let me make sure this is 15, because this map is bigger than what you see here. Okay, so it's got all of the United States on here. But anyway, I guess that's all that's visible right now in this extent. Okay, so let's move on to the next thing that we want to talk about in our query builder. And remember, all these things can be used in any of the expression builders in QGIS. Another way to do this specific comparison is to say, okay, area land, and now I want to do all, or actually click area land, all, and I want to say, well, I want an area land between, okay, between a specific range. Now, the only difference between this and the other one is that the order matters, because you're not telling which is the greater than equal to or less than equal to. So the first one needs to be the smallest. So let's go ahead and, did I click all on this? Between, it seems like, okay, I do have all of them. All right, so area of land between the least, and let's see, what do I want to be the least? 240 million? Is that a million? Nah, that's billion. Okay, let's see, 3, 3, 3. Yeah, that's billion. All right, so we'll do that. Close parenthesis or close quotation marks. That's going to be our least, and our largest. So let's make our largest something bigger than that. Okay, so we just do this 408. There and there. So now that the order is in the right place, we have our smallest and then our largest here. We can test this. And we see there are 7 in between. So I did area of land between this and this. Now, you got to understand, this can be used for multiple things, not just area of land. It can be used for IDs. It can be used for any kind of numerical values, heights, elevations, things like that, that will be in your attribute table for your vector data. Okay, so what's the next thing I want to talk about? We got a couple of buttons up here that are actually words, like, and, or, in, not in. So let's run through those really quick. Let's do like first. Now, there's a like here, and then there's a I like. What does that mean? Well, the I means insensitive. Insensitive to case. So it's insensitive to the case, but they literally work the exact same. Okay, the only difference is this is insensitive to the case. So let's look for, let's go to names. We can look through the names, all the names here. I want to look for names that start with the letter D. Okay, so let's just say, well, we want a name like, and we'll say we want it to start with the letter D. How do we do that? We do single quotations to tell it that we're giving it a string to compare. And I want it to start with the letter D, right? Well, if we just test this, it's basically going to go into the program and say, well, there's nothing here that only has a D in it. So how do we simulate the rest of the word? Where we're going to use a wild card, and this wild card will be the percent sign. So we'll put D in there, and then we'll put our wildcard percent sign. So that means all we want is something that starts with D, no matter how long this word is. All right, so now we'll test this test. We have 134 rows that start with the letter D. Okay, so we'll go and we'll click all to give us a examples of what we have here in this expression. And you can see everything here starts with the letter D. All right, so what happens if we want to see letters that end with D? Well, we'll just put the percent sign in front of the letter D and test it. Okay, so we have 170. We'll go to all, and we'll see these all end with the letter D. Now, remember, this is not some kind of small way to do this. You can put whatever you want in here. You can put AND, and we can test that. AND. On the other side, you can also do it on the other side of the parentheses. Okay, it can be as long as you want it to, but all it's going to do is say, okay, I'm going to look through all the names, and I'm looking for names that end with these three characters. All right, so the next thing is, what if we want to look for things that include something in the middle of a specific word? Well, in that case, we will surround it with percent signs. So let's just say ER, I don't know, what can be in the middle? Let's just put ER, and we'll test that. And we see it's 431 rows that have an ER included in the name. So if I go to sample, see, we have BER, ER here at the end, ER. Wherever the ER is encapsulated, that's what we're looking for. It doesn't necessarily have to end with ER, and that's why we put the percent sign or the wild card back here on the end of it. It doesn't have to end with it, but these did end with it, okay? The next thing, that's containing those values. Now, what about specific positions of a value? So let's say if we are looking for ER, but we want, or actually let's put AN, but we want specific positions before the AN. So what we will use is another wild card called an underscore. So you have the percent sign, and then you have the underscore. The percent sign is right here as a button, but the underscore, you would hit your shift. If you're on a Windows computer, shift, and then it's right beside the plus symbol, beside the zero, right above the minus sign. So that's the underscore. And how many positions do we want in front of the AN before it occurs? So let's say if we had, that's three positions, and we'll test that. We have 34, so let's go ahead and take a sample. We have three positions here, 1, 2, 3, A-N. We have three positions here, 1, 2, 3, A-N. All right, so as you can see, these can be very useful to delegate and to narrow down what you're looking for. And it's the same thing on the other side of the equation. If you wanted something that started with A-N and then it has two positions behind it, or more. So you can actually, if you want to do the or more, you just leave the percent sign on there. But you can do the AN and then just two positions behind it. Let's see if anything, zero. But if I put the parenthesis or the percent sign back here and test, we'll see we have 15 there. Okay, sample, we have the AN, and the percent sign just means there can be more on to it. All right, so that is the locations around the word. And now for the last one, if we want something that, let's say it starts with A, but it ends with a specific letter like T. Okay, we can just put a percent sign in between there and test that. We have three rows. We'll take a sample size. And as you can see, as long as it starts with A, ends with T, we're in the green. All right, for the last ones that we have here, and, or, and not are pretty self-explanatory, but then we have the in and the not in. The in and the not in is basically searching through a specific field to say, is this in or is this not in? So let's go ahead and make that happen. So let's say if we're using the state FP, and I want to say something is in or not in the state FP, or it's kind of like a true or false statement. So state FP in parentheses string 32. Okay, and we'll test that. What is this in our state FP? Basically is what it's saying. And yes, it has 17 rows there. So that's how you use the in, and it's the same thing for the not in. So you just put not here, not in, and we'll test. And of course, now I need to show you this. It's going to give, so remember the 32 was Nevada. If I hit OK, and OK, you'll see that not in, this is what it does. I want everything that's not in Nevada. Now let's go back to our query builder. I think I've done everything here. Of course, there's different variations, and all of this is the SQL language, but it's only scratching the surface, guys. So if you have any questions or comments, please let me know. Hopefully this was something that was useful to you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.